My name is Nick Leister, and I'm a member of the SolidWorks training team. In this multi-video series, I will show you how to start with SolidWorks as I model a pair of needle-nose pliers. In this video, the fourth in the series, I'll show you how to use the mirror feature to replicate a cut on the opposite side of a plane. I'll also show you how to use the fillet command to round off this model's sharp corners. Let's get started. I'll start by mirroring the cut extrude to the other side of the part, making the needle-nose pliers pointy at the end. To create this mirrored feature, I'll click Mirror from the Features tab of the Command Manager. Now, I'll select the Mirror Plane. The Property Manager shows the Mirror Face Plane field active, so I'll use the tree to select the front plane. I'll activate the Features to Mirror field. I could select the feature from the Feature Manager tree flyout. However, I'll select the face from the cut feature created on the model. The preview displays the intended outcome, so I'll click OK. Now, I'll add fillets to the model. Fillets round off sharp corners, removing material on outside corners and adding material on inside corners. I can access the Fillet command from the Features tab of the Command Manager. The Fillet Property Manager contains many options to create fillets with varying shapes and inputs. I'll keep the Constant Size Fillet option selected under Fillet Type. I'll also keep the fillet's default radius dimension at 1/10 of an inch. With the Items to Fillet selection field active, I'll select this edge. A pop-up appears, which I'll focus on later, but ignore for now, and I'll select the mirrored edge. I'll activate the Full Preview option to show what the fillets will look like. Now, I'll rotate the part and select the edge on the handle. Here, I'll use the pop-up, which allows me to select additional edges based on my selection. I'll click the Connected to End Face option, which automatically selects the other three edges belonging to the handle. Finally, I'll rotate the part and select the face on the bottom. Adding lots of fillets to the model becomes easy when selecting faces and using the pop-up. Filleted edges are often small, and picking the wrong entity is easy. If you make an accidental selection, right-click the entity from the Property Manager and click Delete. Finally, I'll click OK. The part looks great, and I'm ready to save it to the platform using a collaborative space and bookmarks I created earlier. Check out the video titled Beginner's Guide to SolidWorks, 3D Experience Platform for SolidWorks to learn more about the platform setup featured in this series. In the video, Beginner's Guide to SolidWorks, Your First Part, I use the Save dropdown to save the pin to the 3D Experience platform. Here, I'll use the Task Pane's 3D Experience tab. I'll start by selecting the part and clicking Save Active Window, which opens the Save to 3D Experience pop-up. I'll enter handle under SW title, and with the Nicholas Workspace collaborative space active, I'll expand the bookmark dropdown. I referenced the pliers bookmark when I saved the pin, so it now appears in the Select from Recent flyout, which saves me from browsing through my bookmarks. I'll scroll to the right to verify the settings. Remember, when I click Save, the platform automatically populates the revision and maturity state properties. I'll click Save, which updates the properties and icons in the task pane. The top of the page also provides information. A cloud icon next to the part's name indicates the model's saved status within the platform's cloud. Additionally, the model is not locked, so I can edit and save it, but must then change its revision state. However, this also means that my colleagues with leader access to my collaborative space can edit this model. A flyout by the Feature Manager design tree also provides quick access to this information. The part is saved to the platform, it's unlocked, it's revision A, and the checkmark indicates I'm working with the latest revision. Finally, I'll collapse the menu and close the part. In the following video, I'll create an assembly that includes the pin and two instances of the handle. I'll also explore how mates constrain the motion of parts in an assembly. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, watch the following video in this series and visit the site below to access a complete SolidWorks CAD Fundamentals playlist.